Hi, my name is Grace Mora. I'm a student from KC National Polytechnic. Today I'm here to give about my story. First of all, I want to thank this platform because it has really enabled, it really educates people, helps people to learn about life and how life is. Today I'm going to give about my love story. It's so kind of complicated, but in primary I never had any crush or a love. Nikaenda high school I used to have many more male friends, so I never concentrated in dating, though I was in a mixed school. Nilisoma Gesiaga high school. Alafu pia my dressing code never allowed me to kukatiwa. Yeah, so nikafika college. Yeah, in college things became more a bit complicated, let me say so. Then due to pressure, people thinking that I'm a lesbian, nikasema let me start dating. First of all, I dated some guy. Yeah, he was so very cute. Due to pressure, nilimwona ni cute na blah blah blah, so we started dating. It never lasted for 2 weeks. Because obvious cute guys hawezi kosa other girls wa kudate. So mimi niliona haina haja ya ku force issues with someone. So nikatulia. Then relationship ya pili, I met a guy alikuwa nakuja kwa my best friend sana. He was so cute, talented, gifted. He was even a dancer. So Leona, let me just use the opportunity. Pia na yali nikatia, we started dating. Then we dated for a while, like a month. And then nikaanza kuna red flags, like they are okay. We used to call a lot. Calls zika tulia, texting zika chill. Then tukaona yenyewe na easy make. And you know, you cannot force something to happen if it's not there. So I gave up. Then I decided to chill for a while. When nilienda attachment, which was last year on September, I was doing very well. Kuna site flying tukua tunaenda at a place called Nyanchwa. That site, I'm doing actually civil engineering, so nilikuwa nimeenda attachment. In the site, there was a guy who came for an internship. Yeah, I will not say his name though. That guy was so very cute, ambitious. He was a very good guy. Actually, I never noticed him because I was back home sick, and I was told by my other colleagues, like, hey, there's a guy who's here, he's an intern, he really knows a lot. Even the engineer told me you should learn from that guy. So the next day when I went to the site, I found him. We started talking, sharing a lot. We used to talk a lot and much. So in the process of talking, vibing, we started feeling like a bit close, having some deep feelings to each other. So mimi nilichukulia like, maybe it's so normal because najua kuna ule msi unaweza pata unasema mna vibe kidogo kidogo mpate ka feeling kama ingia mkoe friends, but this was extreme. Like I felt that, hey, I'm in love with this guy, and this love I will not leave it to waste, because I was trying to get a boyfriend, but this chance has come, so let me use it wisely. Then we started talking and talking. He also had some feelings to me, so tukaka chini kamambia nyewe, me to be honest, I like you. I made the first move. I told him, yo, I like you, and I see that we can tuneza vibe and we can really date, because the qualifications that I want, you have it. The qualifications that you want, I have it. So we can date. So then it was so. Yeah, he took me on our first date. It was really enjoying. We spent time together. We shared a lot. We exchanged a lot. We really had a great time. It was very, very nice. Yeah, we tukaendelea hivyo tukienda site, like we never wanted even the engineers to know that we were dating. So it got to keep low key. But inside to quite to like we are friends. So people used to love us. Walikuwa wanatoa na sema, hey, though walikuwa na suspect, but we were like, no, we just friends. But in the real sense, we were dating. I loved the company when I was with him kwa site. Yeah, he was very, very a great guy. Then after a few months of dating and all that, our conversations zikaanza kuwa low. So because that was the first relationship imeenda for more than 3 months. So I was like, I counted myself lucky, but things started changing. And I felt like, I think I'm in my own world. So nikaamua kumuliza like, hey, I feel like you're starting to change. So he's like, no, you know, things zimeanza kukua venye zinakuwa, like nimekuwa busy. And I'm like, well, it's okay. Mimi nikamaliza attachment, nikaenda home. Then bado nikiwa home, we were still talking. But kuna venye nilianza kufeel like something is not right here. Actually niliwahi toka home nikakuja kumsalimia to mali alikuwa anakaa. Though anaishi nyumbani kuna place naye alikuwa amerent, though that house alikuwa anaenda once in a while. So nikamwa niende nimsalimie. Tukaenda tukakaa, we talked, but going okay, I never wanted to go through his phone. So yeye ndiye aliamua buy data anze kuview status. Tukaanza kuview status. He's like, no, you can just see my phone. So me was like, eh? I never wanted to see your phone, but anyways, you insist, let me just look at it. Eh, kuangalia, I can see, niliona some madem wamesaviwa na malave emojis. Mini kiangalia, nimesaviwa tu na jina. Okay, hiyo ikuni pressure because hata mimi yenyewe kwa simu yangu, I never saved anyone with any love emoji. So I was like, it's okay. Niliangalia, then nikaona his ex. Kuna design alikuwa amemsave, nilikuwa funny. So I was like, anyway, let me just let it slide. Nikaenda home, but that was really hitting me different. There is a time I felt that we really messed up. Like, literally, like, really, I felt so. But God ni nani? God did his things, kukaenda sawa. But things kept on changing. Kila kitu ilianza kuchange kabisa. He started showing like he never cares. I used to call him a lot more than he could. So I didn't mean kona yenyewe hapa, I'm not wanted. Hata kama nilikuwa bro enough nasema eh, nili humble sana nikasema because of love, let me do this. Because of love, let me do whatever he tells me. Yeah, though he never shouted at me, though he never akuwa ni beat, akuwa nifanyia shit. Nilikuwa tunavumilia nasema anyway, because I love this guy, let me just chill. Hey, but things started getting more worse till this year on January. Yeah, tulimaliza nikarudi shule. Then I'm an actor and I'm a singer, I'm a drama, like mimi napenda kufanya drama and music thing. So he started to use excuses like mispendi wasichana wa drama, mispendi actors, mispendi oh kwanza watu wa drama mkienda backdrops, you know you guys do nasty shit there. So I'm like, that's how highly you think of me, but it's okay. I'll try to quit drama because of you, all because of love. I wanted to quit everything because I really loved that guy. But a certain teacher called me, akaanza kuniambia, Grace, you've really changed because you're not interested anymore in drama because that's what nimekulea nayo. That was my teacher from, alikuwa amenitrain drama kutoka form 1. So aliona ni kama naanza kuslide. So he was like, is there something that's hindering you from quitting drama? Just fikiria kwanza mara mbili. Eh, nyewe nilikaa tu chini kasema, eh, drama is something that has brought me up. Drama is something that has been paying my fee. Drama is something that has helped me to grow physically and mentally. And I'm like, okay, let me just try to give it a shot. So I went and talked to him, kamwambia nyewe, for real, to be honest, hey, so nikikuit drama na music, because that's what has brought me up. That's what has been even paying my fee. Alikubali but chingu upande, so nikamwa tu, wacha tu tusonge mbele. Then kidogo, we started going to festivals. Before I could go to the festival, it was like a week before festivals are drama. It was drama. He decided to reach out to me. Akanipigia kanambia, hey, hi, how are you? Nikamambia, I'm good. Nikamambia, before I go to stage, I think I should come and see you. So he was like, no, I'm not. Currently, I'm not in Kisii, I'm in Nairobi. So I was like, eh, mwena Nairobi na ujaniambia. Then credit, kido credit ikaenda, akanikola. Akanambia, nye, Gracie, to be honest, I think we should be friends. I don't think we should date anymore. So I was like, do you time nilikuwa na pressure kuingia stage ndio hiyo, like my items zilikuwa mingi na mimi ndo nilikuwa main cast kwa hizo zote. Haikuni hit sana. So I was like, are you sure that you want us not to date anymore? He was like, yeah. We should not date anymore. I think we should be friends because enyewe hata nimeshindwa kukuambia tusikue friends because I see that you're talented, you're a good girl, but I don't want us to date anymore. I want us to be friends. Nilitikia tu because I had no choice. And I will never had to force any relationship. So I couldn't hit sana. Juu hata hivyo nilikuwa na pressure ya drama na nini. So sikuwa nifikiria sana. Nilikuwa fikiria, how am I going to perform in that drama festival? At least I could qualify in the nationals. But anyway, I talked to him. Akaniambia, yo, nini, nini. He never mentioned what was behind the scenes. Then mimi nilienda festivals, nikamaliza. After nimemaliza tu festivals hivi, actually by that time nilikuwa naishi na wazazi, sikuenda home. I went to a friend's house. I literally sikuwa naamini, like hapo ndili hit, like nyewe nimeacha, saidi na hit, like nimeacha, na nilikuwa nimeambiwa like 3 days ago. It really hit me differently after all the things that we did, after everything that I went through because of that guy. Anyway, hata kama nikuwa gangster aje, it really hurted me. I really cried. It really, anyway, ilikuwa ndani yangu nasema, I love this guy. I almost quitted everything. All my career, kitu nilimwambia tu aniache naye ni drama. Akaamua tu kunifanyia hivyo. Akasema, it's okay, I'll just move on. Then I called him and asked him about his new girlfriend. Kumbe ilikuwa ni ex wake. And I was suspecting of that because nilikuanga na certain feeling that he still liked his ex. Because every time angeniambia, unajua tamanzi yangu, unajua alikuwa anafanya hivi, alikuwa anafanya hivi. So I'm like, why are you bringing ex up when we are dating? Because that's your past. So then I learned that all of that was because of his ex. Na ex wake pia alikuwa amemdump. Kumbe alikuwa bado anampenda. Kumbe hata kama alimdump pia demu na ile na kadampiwa akaamua kurudi kwa the guy that I was currently dating. So I was like, anyway, since you decided to leave, I can't force you not to leave. I can't force you to stay. I can't beg you to stay. I just have to accept the fact that I have to let you go. So niliamua ku let go. But hata kama nili let go, he still had feelings for me. So he used to call me daily and I'm like, I needed these calls, but they were no longer there when I needed them. They're coming when I'm not needing them. Nilimwambia, enyewe, since we're dating, I think we should keep a very bad distance because exes never like when you're dating, nobody, like, demu yako ama chali yako, hawezitaka kuongea na ex wako. So I was like, no, don't talk to me anymore. If you want to call me, just maybe kwetu once. Ama kama ka job kametokea, because all of us are engineers, we can talk about a project, tufanya project. Lakini when it comes to relationships and kind of feeling things, let it not work. So from then I learned a lesson, knowing that, okay, love is a beautiful thing. I can never say that I'll never date again. I'll sure do dates. Yeah, I'll sure do dates. Love is a really beautiful thing. It's just that we never get to get the right people to be on our side. We only fall in the hands of the wrong people. And falling in the hands of the wrong people is really nice thing because inakusaidia unafungua brain, unajua what's supposed to happen. Unajua, you learn, actually we learn from mistakes. There's this methali ama proverb which says that we do learn from our mistakes. So falling in the hands of the wrong people, pia, it's a lesson for us to know whatever we choose, whatever we do is right. Tunafanya ni mbaya. Like it really opens our minds and our brains. So though we tuliachana, we still do talk. Tunafanya projects pamoja sometimes. Pia nilikuanga na sistake anaundanga keki. So uanga nampatia, uanga nakuanga plug sometimes. Kama mtu anataka keki naenda namfanya two orders. And but we still do talk. Adi nikimpata by the way, but ni kama pia alienda kadampiwa na huyo msichana tena. Right now though we do talk, he's really confessing that he really wants me back. And in the look of things, yeah, I really love that guy. Hata kwanza ni mtu angeniambia tu, if you're given a chance to date your ex, will you date him again? Hey, wallahi mimi ningesema yeah. Yeah, mina ningekubali kabisa. Like, I really love that guy. I did a lot to that guy. I just, a lot of things when we were dating. And it was the first relationship that ilikuwa imepushiwa for long, like kutoka September. Hey, kutoka October last year. Yeah, ikasonga-songa. It was the first relationship ilisonga, and I think it was my fourth relationship. Yeah, na kwanza kudate nilianza nikiwa college, so how sucks it was. But anyway, I really learned a lesson. It opened my mind. Nikajua, like, if you want a partner, if you want a boyfriend or someone who you can be intimate with, you have to think twice. You have to choose wisely, not see random guy at you, like, you know, let me, ama unapewa mtu na mtu nambiwa, nikuna bishitangu hapa na niku, ako single. Kani uneza mneza date? Mnapata mneza kudate? No. When it comes to love, you have to think twice. Because love is something sweet. Very, very sweet. And at times, it's bitter. So very bitter. So we have to think twice when it comes to love. Loving someone is not a mistake, but it can be some kind sort of a lesson to someone. Yeah. The man may say, when falling into a wrong person, Pia, usoi regret. By the way, I never regretted dating all those guys because at least I was learning something. Najua kijana apendi hii, anapenda hii, anachukia hii, anapenda hii. So like, unajua nyewe, these guys want this and that. So unajua next time in a relationship, I should do this and should do that. So, hadi sometimes ningekaa chini ninasema, in these relationships zote, nimeachwa. Siti ni mindo nimesema, acha niache huyu kijana. Ni mindo nimeachwa. Am I the person who is in a mistake? To all girls out there, baby girl, you're not a mistake. It's just that you fall in the wrong hands. And we have to think twice when it comes to love. Because love is a bit, hey, nyewe, mapenzi ni tamu. Jesus, mapenzi ya nyewe ni so, so, so sweet. Yeah, and to friends out there who are heartbroken, it doesn't mean that it's the end of the world. I know it's not. Maybe it was preparing you to get someone who's right for you. Yeah. It was preparing to get someone who's suitable for you. And maybe, who knows, it's a future husband. Guys out there, there are some wenye wako campus na bado wame, they are married na wako campus. And they still live a beautiful life until they are married. They get kids. They do their own things. So, it depends na where your fate and destiny is and whenever it lies. So, we should never give up on love. And to those who are still dating, try to be loyal to your boyfriends and girlfriends, because me in relationship, I do trust that trust is key. If I really don't trust you, then you're not dating. But when I'm dating you, I give you complete trust. Complete trust. And yata nikisike tunachite, tumtu anembe yo, you're cheating. I can't believe that because I trust you, you will not cheat. That's what I know. Complete trust is everything in a relationship. But once trust in apotea, there's no relationship there. It's just that you're just showing off. Yeah. So, to all guys out there, love is a beautiful thing. Let's think before we act. That's all for today. And thank you guys for everything. Pia kwenye mnasoma msome bana, huku maisha ni mbaya ukunze. Bye guys. Bye.